to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing. I surrender all to you, everything I give to you, withholding nothing, withholding.
In the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you, God, for just giving us the opportunity to come and to share here at Hope RHEMA Word Community Church. And Lord, we ask you to continue to bless this ministry down here in Waldorf, Maryland. God, we ask you to continue to remember the shepherd of this house and those that are in, under the leadership of this tutelage. Lord, we ask you to let the anointing, God, continue to flow, God, in this place.
Yes.
We ask you to bless, oh God, his wife and stand beside him. Co-founder. God, we ask you to continue to remember each and every one that's under the sound of his voice. As they minister, they come alongside to work in the ministry. We ask you to bless them. Turn it around. God, those things, lives that need to be turned around. God, nothing just happened by happenstance. As you bring them in from various ways, various places, you know how to do it. And God, we give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. Your son Jesus' name, our soul said, amen, amen, amen,
amen.
Amen. We just bless God. I do want to say that I may be sort of new, but I'm no stranger. I see you got, you know, got one Lord, one faith, one baptism.
Yes.
Amen. So you got the Bible sign. And, you know, I have to say, I have to help you get a little comfortable. And I'm a Bible and baby.
So right. Amen. Yes, amen.
And you feel comfortable. I'm that crazy off the wall Jack Lane preacher. Somebody say something.
Amen. Exactly.
About the gospel of the temple.
Right.
My pastor was Bishop Bridges and Bishop John Lane.
Amen.
Amen. Both of them, my pastor. Amen. I came up the ranks. You know, now some preachers are preachers and they never did anything.
Wow. Uh-oh. Make it fun. Oh, watch out.
This is the first, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
And you asked me to come.
Yes,
oh, no, you asked me to come. And she said, please get it on the books now that you do that. I came up the ranks, amen. I came up the ranks, amen, from a crazy place. You know, when you brought up in church, sometimes your upbringing in church, sometimes you don't get anywhere. Y'all help me somebody.
Amen.
Y'all want me to be real or you want me to just play with it?
No, be real, be real.
Take a minute and say, I better say something. They got 2 hours before. listen. You know, I heard my brother say he came from, you know, with God brought him from a nightclub. And God brought me off the floor of my bedroom. Amen. OD, dope in my system.
Yes.
God delivered me, set me free. He gave me an opportunity. Amen. Not only to just come to him, but to just get in now, not just come to church, but to get in church. And the church get in me. And that got to the place where, as a brother, God, he started blessing. God does things in a strange way. Amen. He hear this guy, this little kid that was running all over the church. Now, God saves him. God fills him with the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Amen. He get on fire for the Lord. Amen. Some kind of way, I saw this young man, amen, up, and he's, you know, he's practicing being the deacon and practicing.
Amen.
Something up here. That's how they hand me. They hand me up front and practice. I scared it all over. Somebody help me with that. I know how you shake it in the boots, but keep doing what you're doing. Don't let nobody stop you from doing what you're doing. Keep on doing it.
I'm right.
Everybody got a beginning.
Yeah.
And your beginning is not going to be like somebody else's.
That's
beginning.
Right. Yeah.
Just come. I got a word. I got a word. Just calm down.
Yeah.
Just calm down. I went from a brother, amen, to a deacon. And I went from a deacon on into ministry, into the eldership. And then from elder on out to pastor. And then from pastor on into being the bishop and the bishopric. And from a bishopric all into being a presider. Somebody help me in this place.
Amen.
Hey, all happens because, amen, my mother was a praying woman.
Yeah.
All
right. Yeah.
She prayed, amen. But I remember when we started Word of Faith Church. I remember the schedule. It was April 4th, 1996. When we started Word of Faith, it was interesting because we had, amen, all of us with you do, my brother. What's
amen.
That? What's my name? You.
Flowers.
Flowers. We had what you do.
Right.
My brother-in-law, he was, you know, he was rough band, clubbing and all that kind of stuff. And he could play, you know, he could play what he knew how to play. He didn't sound like he was still in the club, but he could play. One of the things that I found out about God, God will use anybody that want to be used.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
And he won't use me like he used somebody else.
That's right.
And you know what I found out, Bishop? I found out it's best for me to be the best me I can be.
Amen, Bishop.
I'm the best me, amen, I can be. Amen. And can't nobody else be better than me. You know why? Because he met me.
I'm not sure that's right.
Here we have two scriptures. One is Acts 20 chapter. I didn't give you the other one. The other one is Psalm of God. You get fresh if you get Acts 20:29. And Elder Dyes, you would get Psalm 73. 1, 2, 3, and then skip down to 73. Acts 20 chapter. I just want to just say amen to you. God has been good to you. He has blessed you. He brought you through a year. Amen. Come on, Elder Frazier.
Acts 20:29.
Uh-huh.
For I know this. That after my departing. Shall grievous wolves. Enter among you.
Uh-huh.
Not sparing the flock.
And the church says,
amen.
Amen. Paul was writing, he was telling, amen, the young preacher that he's got to leave. And when he leaves, watch out.
Yes.
Because grievous wolves are going to come in.
Wow.
Amen. And sometimes we can get so gullible and so aggressive and want people to come and join us. But we're not careful. Person can join us.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking to y'all.
Yes,
hey,
amen.
I know I could be slapping my head, screaming and hollering. You don't hear a word I say.
Yeah.
One thing I do know is the enemy will not allow this church to prosper, to do what God asks it to do, unless it comes and attack it.
Wow.
When you start doing what God has to do, wants you to do, the enemy knows he cannot stop it. Cannot destroy it.
Amen.
He understands. Jesus said, upon this rock I'll build my
church,
and the gates of hell shall not
prevail.
So that must mean if he can't destroy it, he can't stop it, he must join it. Oh, y'all, I'm preaching. Oh, I know what it is. Y'all standing. I told y'all I'm tired too, didn't I? I got you tonight. Look at you, listen. He got me. Come on, Psalm 73.
Psalm 73.
Uh-huh.
And the word of the Lord reads.
Yes.
Truly God is good to Israel. Even to such as are of a clean heart.
Listen, God is good to Israel. He's good to those that have a clean heart. Read.
But as for me,
uh-huh,
my feet were almost gone.
Here, ASAP, amen, one that was brought up in church.
Amen.
He's making a declaration about how his foot almost slipped.
Wow.
Okay? And sometimes in church,
yes, sir,
we can almost slip.
Wow.
Look at your name, I know that's right. Come on, read that.
My steps,
uh-huh,
had well nigh slipped.
Uh-huh.
Verse 3. For I was envious at the foolish.
Listen. Why should I be envious at foolish folks? Why should I give attention to somebody that's foolish? This is the first anniversary, right?
Yes, sir.
I want y'all to remember this. I want you to understand that when foolish folks come in your face, don't even give them the time of day.
All right.
I'm trying to get them saved. Not when they foolish.
No.
When you try to tell them about Jesus and they tell you that I don't want it, you shake the dust off the feet and call them somebody that want it. Don't cast this word to the... Oh, come on, read.
When I saw the prosperity of the wicked.
Read again.
For I was envious at the foolish. When I saw the prosperity of the wicked.
Here we look at what the world is doing. We look at what other churches are doing. And some of these other churches are wicked.
Amen.
We always think wicked folks are sinners.
Not all.
But he gave us a Bible prescription up to the church.
That's right.
Yeah. He said, little children sin not.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Right? But if you sin, you have an advocate with the Father.
Yes.
Right? Why would he give us a prescription about falling?
Wow.
He wasn't talking to sinners, he was talking to the church.
Yeah.
Right? So we have a, sometimes we get in a place where we start watching what the wicked does. And watch what other churches are doing.
Yes.
And we try to emulate them and try to do what they, don't try to do what somebody else do. Stay on your knees and ask God, what should we do?
Yeah.
What should RHEMA, what should Hope RHEMA Word do?
Yeah.
How should we build this ministry?
Yes.
How should God, what does God say inside of you? Not what somebody else said, what does God say with us? Oh, God. Listen, God will give you a word and you think, hey, well, they don't want that. You hear Norm Jones with somebody else on TV and you think that's what God wants you to. God gave that to him. Norm got that word. Somebody help me here. He's got a word for you.
Yes.
Don't watch what other folks do. Listen, read.
Verse 17.
17.
Until I went to the sanctuary of God.
Now, when your feet start slipping and your feet start, you know, your eyes start being focused and misdirected, amen, you got to remember every time you come into the sanctuary, every time I come in here, I'm going to bless God.
Yes.
Exactly. See, ASAP, amen, he remember what God did for y'all to be seen. I'm sorry. Do you see what happened? It's amazing how the preacher got to stand all the time. And Doug can't stand up. Amen. Well, Israel, they had to stand up while the scripture was read.
Yes.
And while the minister was stood, preached.
Amen.
They stood up.
Yes.
Right. They stood up. Because they reverence God's word.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you here, at RHEMA, we need to reverence God's word.
Yeah.
Amen. This first anniversary, I want you to reverence God's word. I want you to lose sight, lose focus about God's word. Amen. The word that we hide in our heart, that we don't sin against him, we got to reverence that word.
Yeah.
We got to know that that word is true and it's not coming back void. Come on. I'm telling you, went into the sanctuary of God. Yes.
Then understood and therein.
See, at the end, amen, ASAP, he realized that while he was watching and envious and looking at what the world was doing and what the other church was doing, and they were prospering, it seemed like they didn't miss no beat. Amen. And we sitting back here complaining and murmuring to God, wondering, well, when our time is going to come? Amen. Your time is going to come when it comes. We have to keep doing what God signed to our hands to do. And we can't give up. We can't stop. When I looked at what ASAP was and what he was doing, ASAP was down there, him and David, amen, we found that they were skillful men, amen. They were skills, they were musicians. That's why I picked on you, amen. Amen, I know my brother, that's why. They were musicians. Him and David was not just musicians, but they were poets.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody, help me.
Yeah.
They wrote poets, they wrote songs, they were musically inclined, amen. And so they were anointed, amen, to do service in God's house. And when you are anointed to do service in God's house, you got to watch out because the enemy will try to prostitute you. Amen. Yes, he would. Just like you tried taking it on. I said, I know that did. Took it out. Amen. Out of the nightclub, bring them in the church. And trying now to take them out of the church and take them to a nightclub. Come on, somebody help me. This place is not a go-go. Somebody help me in this place. This is not a Jew joint.
Yeah.
So suddenly look at this text and I realize, amen, there's some negative things that can happen to us that can draw us away from God. One, there could be negative people. Negative folks, negative people, amen, that's so negative, they can draw you away from God if you're not careful. They can tell you, man, I wouldn't go there, man. You know how far Waldorf is?
Come on, Bishop.
You say you can't be careful in Heights, I can't even move. You say you real wrong. Come on, come on, help me. Amen. It's just as far. Come on here.
Yeah.
But we got staff at Virginia sitting behind you. We got real in Pikesville somewhere. Come on, somebody help me. You see, when you got a mind to do what God said do, don't worry about what other folks say.
That's
too far. I don't even know. There's a church right around the corner. Why don't you go around the corner? Because God ain't sent me around the corner.
Come on, Bishop.
Said, or people will draw you out of where God has planted you. This is the other one for the pastor and Lady Paulette. Amen. This is for the church. You need to bloom where you're planted.
Yeah.
Right. If God planted you here in this first year, you are bloom. Somebody help me here. Somebody said, well, how do I bloom? I'm going to get so big that I'm going to grow. I'm going to grow so large that I'm going to overgrow this church. I'm going to go somewhere else back and get a word. Listen here, you're not going to get no more different of a word no matter whoever get it. So I said, well, I can learn more. Well, you can't go other places to learn, but you don't go other places to learn to stay there. You go there, so you go back home and practice what you learn. Y'all help me in this place. You have to learn how to practice what you learn. Come back and do whatever folks do. If other folks got a big ministry going on, go there and find out what they're doing in that ministry. How did they get their youth to do what they're doing? What can the youth do? They can do that. I'm taking it back. I'm going back home and we're going to implement that. I just got a word. Because sometimes we lose focus on what God has spoke to us. And negative folks can get us off track if we let go. Tell your neighbor, don't lose focus.
Don't allow anybody
to shift your focus. Point number two. Come on. Listen. Don't allow things to distract you and get you off course.
All right.
I know it sounds close to the negative folks, but sometimes it's things. Sometimes we can get distracted by things.
Amen.
And things can cause us, amen, to get distracted. I'm telling you, have you ever noticed when a person is always in trouble, they always run to the altar and run to God?
Mm-hmm. Wow.
As soon as God blesses them, they go on out and they don't need them no more.
About their way. Wow.
And so I can tell you a good distraction. You ride the bus all the time and then all of a sudden you get a car.
Huh?
Amen.
Come on, Bishop.
This is the first time. This is what you need. Trust me. You need somebody to come in, amen, and just tell it just like a TIE is. I wish I had somebody to come in. Come on. You get distracted. You get a brand new car. Now you got a car. You don't ride the bus no more. So all of a sudden now you can't come to church because you got to work extra. And you don't understand, Pastor, how it worked extra to pay for this car. Then I question whether God gave you that car. Because when God gives you something, there's no hindrance. There's nothing, no strings attached to him. Only thing that's attached to him is when he gives you some conditional thing.
Yeah,
one of the conditional things is you live right.
Yeah.
Come on, you obey his word. Come on, somebody help me in his place. You stand in his word. Well, what kind of things can distract me and take me away from God? And then when you start looking at other things, it's in the book.
Yeah.
ASAP said, I almost fainted, I almost slipped, watching the prosperity of the wicked. If somebody rolled by me in a Rolls Royce, I'm going to look at that Rolls Royce.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to pay quite good attention. My God, look at the details in it. But guess what? I ain't going to the assembly line. I ain't going to the dealer. I know. I'm not going to the dealer tomorrow.
to pick out no rose. I'm not going to do that because somebody else got one.
Right.
I'm going to pick out whatever I want to pick out.
That's right.
And when I pick the car that I want to pick out, I'm going to be able to pay for it and drive it. And put gas in it. See, we can get so caught up in what others do that we try to emulate them and try to do what they do. And when you do what other folks do, you become a clone.
Yes, sir.
Oh, God. But if you do it, God, call on him in times of trouble. Yes. Call on him when there's no trouble. Yes. Call on him when there's peace. Call on him when all hell is breaking out. Learn how to call on God in the time of trouble, David said. I called on the Lord and he heard. With God. Amen. When you got a church that can pray, can't no devil in hell, they can't stop you. Amen. I told you they'll come in here and join the church. They will.
Yes, sir.
I had folks that come to join the church. They had little white suits on, a little white hat, and then all of a sudden at the end of the service, they jumped up, prophesying, hollering, and screaming, and I had to sit down in the name of Jesus. Somebody help me in this place. Lord, listen here. You can't let no renegades, no fools, no crazy folks come in this church. Church of the living God. You got power. After the Holy Ghost come upon you, you shall receive power. Power for what? Power for the enemy to run over you? No weapon that's formed against me. You got to understand, amen, the dynamics of who you are in God. Amen, I'm so happy, amen, you brought me down here. I'm glad that everybody didn't come with me. I'm going to get on. They will hear from me.
Yes, sir.
But it happens to everybody.
Yes, sir.
It happens. Listen, and when you hear somebody say, "Ooh, man, that's nice." You just got practice doing that nice stuff too. You don't have to emulate them, but they don't mean that you don't have to strive for
excellence. That's right.
Right. Learn how to do whatever God wants you to do, but be excellent in it. Yeah. Don't be no slouch. Yeah. No. Just do it with excellence. Listen, tell your neighbor.
Neighbor.
Tell them what?
With holding nothing, with holding.